work in Adobe Digital Learning Services, where our goal as a team is to create innovative learning solutions for our customers. That's fun, engaging, and impactful.
3, 2, 1, go!
Hello!
Hello.
I'm a mom to 4 great kids, and they're just my whole world. They take up every moment of my free time. My husband and I have been married for 22 years, and our day consists of football practice, swim meets, soccer games, lots of laundry, takeout. When I was 4, my mom took me and my sister and she moved us to American Samoa, which is a U.S. territory in the South Pacific. She had just gotten a divorce, and so she wanted to move us home to live with my grandma and grandpa and kind of get the help she needed as a new single mom. The house was just a shack on stilts. I had a lot of extended family around me. I had my cousins, I had my aunts and uncles. And so for me, it never felt like I was lacking, and it never felt unsafe. It felt like home. It felt like a place where I belonged and I felt safe despite lacking the materialistic things that I think we think of today. My first day of kindergarten was really rough. The classroom was an old Samoan hut, or like a fale, and the instruction was all in Samoan. I could not speak Samoan, and I had a really hard time feeling engaged in the learning. And I remember I would go and get these textbooks, these really old textbooks, and I would just read them. I had a hunger and a desire to learn, but I just wasn't getting it in school, and it was really rough. I made the mistake one time of saying, "I don't speak Samoan," and that was really disrespectful to be Samoan and not know how to speak your language. It was almost a betrayal to saying that I was Samoan. I lived in this state of fear almost. I got stabbed in the hand with a pencil. I remember kind of almost getting jumped on the walk home from school. I was just so tired, and I was like, "Mom, you gotta do something. You've gotta fix this. I'm not going to school anymore." She looked at me and she said, "At some point in your life, you are going to need to learn to fight your own battles." Looking back, that was a pivotal moment in my life. I learned that my silence was not protecting me, and it was causing me to avoid people altogether. At that point, I knew I didn't have the energy to be afraid anymore. Eventually, I learned to speak Samoan, and the schoolyard fights were fewer. I think at some point in life, we become a byproduct of our circumstances, for good or bad. And today I work in education, designing impactful learning experiences. Every time I design instruction today, I imagine that fearful, shy little girl that I was, who sat in the back of the classroom, who really isolated. She's constantly reminding me that I need to be inclusive of her. So in every classroom, every meeting room, every boardroom or conference room that I present in, I make sure that she's there, and what I'm doing includes her.